Use the cloud. Just don't rely on the cloud. Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Yes, that sounds like an oxymoron. I'm saying use it, but don't trust it. There's a reason I say that, and it's because I see a lot of people losing data by using the cloud inappropriately. Now, before you say, I don't use the cloud, I don't use OneDrive, I don't use Dropbox, any of those kinds of services, trust me, you're using the cloud. How? Email. Email is probably the oldest cloud service around, and I'm sure you're using it. So everything that I'm about to say applies to all of us. It applies to your email. It applies to all of the other cloud services, most notably the storage services that you may or may not be using. My favorite definition of the cloud is that it's somebody else's computer. You're using somebody else's computer. Whatever service it happens to be it email, well, you're running Gmail, you're using Google's computers. If you're running Outlook.com, you're running Microsoft's computers. You get the idea. It's not your hardware, and you don't set the rules. That is perhaps one of the most important things to understand about any online service. Online storage, be it email or OneDrive, Dropbox, etc., is only one place. That's important, and by now it probably leads you to understand where I'm taking this. Email is easy, right? If you've got a message in your inbox and it's only in your inbox, that's only one place. If you suddenly lose access to that account, that message is gone. That applies to everything in your email account unless you're backing it up. You might think that synchronization services associated with cloud storage, like OneDrive and Dropbox and so forth, don't fall into this one place kind of categorization, but they do. Think about it. If you have, say I'll use OneDrive as my example, if you're using OneDrive, you put a file in OneDrive and it's going to show up in 1, 2, 3, however many computers you have signed into OneDrive at that time, if they're configured to download that file in its entirety. However, it's one place in the sense that if you delete that file, well, it's synchronized. It's going to get deleted from all those places exactly like it was just one place. Like I said, you know where I'm going. If it's in only one place, it's not backed up. That implies that if you're not doing something in addition to using these services, you're probably not backing up that data, and you are at risk of losing it all without warning in an instant. How? The most common way, by far, to lose your online data is to lose access to the account. This is probably the most read, watched topic on Ask Leo for the last, I don't know, maybe 10 years. Basically, people are coming to me trying to recover or regain access to an account for which they've lost the password or has been hacked or something else has happened that is preventing them from being able to sign into the account. Well, if you can't sign into it, you can't get at anything inside. That includes your email, but it also includes any of the associated services that might be associated with that account. That could include OneDrive, Google Drive, Dropbox, if those kinds of things are happening. It could include YouTube videos, videos you've uploaded, if this is your Google account we're talking about. It could include anything, any service that is associated with the account that you no longer have access to. Again, gone in an instant without warning. And often within these account recovery scenarios, without hope of recovery. Now, there's also a frustrating way to lose things in the cloud, and it's not really even our fault, but it happens often enough. And that is either through bad design or misleading buttons or any number of things that just cause us to accidentally do something we didn't intend to do, like, say, delete a file, things can get lost. It gets worse, though. Sometimes the service will change the rules out from underneath you. The biggest example I have of this right now, Microsoft's OneDrive. If you have, I'll just say, a lot of data in your documents folder, maybe, I don't know, let's just say 25 gigs worth of data, and you accidentally turn on or allow to be turned on the OneDrive backup feature, which specifically tells you it's going to back up your documents, your pictures, and so forth, then all of a sudden, your documents folder is moved into OneDrive, all 25 gigs of it. All that gets uploaded. If you've got a free account, you don't have 25 gigs of space. You've only got 5 gigs of space. You may start getting warnings. Eventually, though, OneDrive is going to start deleting files in order to get you down to that 5 gigabyte level. It's trite to say don't turn on the backup feature, but Microsoft is pushing it really hard. It's easy, trivially easy, to accidentally turn it on. And once you turn it on, you've got a problem. But that's an example of changing the rules that inadvertently can cause you to lose data from the cloud. Now, there's a very rare way to lose data from the cloud, and it's the one objection that I actually get most often. What if the service provider goes out of business? Well, yeah, okay, you would lose everything you have with that service provider. However, it's extremely rare. And honestly, it's not something I worry about at all. When you think about it, if you're using large services like Microsoft or Google or any of the others, they're not going out of business. Yeah, they might turn off a feature or a product. Google's notorious for that. But even then, they give you tons of warning. The best example of that most recently is Boxcryptor. When some time ago they decided that they were discontinuing their product, they gave the people using that product like upwards of a year to get themselves off the product before it went away. So lots of notification if it happens, but it happens very, very rarely. And it's just not something I worry about. Another response I get is, well, don't cloud services have backups? I hope so. I really do. The problem with those backups, though, is they're not meant for you and me. Those backups are to protect the service. If they have a hardware problem, if they have a software problem, they have some way to restore all their users' data and recover. Those backups aren't meant for you and me, and they are not accessible to you and me. Which means, again, from our perspective, a backup you can't access is no backup at all. You know the answer. Backup. If you're using cloud-based email, get a desktop email program, synchronize it using IMAP, and you're backed up. That's what I do with Thunderbird. If you're using cloud storage, like OneDrive, like Dropbox, like Google Drive, make sure that you have a copy of everything somewhere else. It could be somewhere else less convenient. That's fine. You can download it to an external hard disk. You can download it to other machines, whatever. The bottom line, though, is that you need to have it in more than one place. And those cloud storage providers each consist of exactly one place. And yeah, if you want to back up your OneDrive to your Dropbox, that's a fine solution, too. But the bottom line is you have to take the initiative to make those things happen. Also, keep the originals when you upload videos or photos. Don't rely on your photo sharing app or your social media app or whatever to A, not mess with the quality. This is something that happens a lot. You upload a very detailed, high quality image or video, and the social media app basically downgrades it. It's still there, it's just not as clear as the original. But more importantly, there's a good chance you can't get it back. Not easily, if at all. So keep the originals, keep your pictures, keep your videos, store them somewhere where it's, again, inconvenient if that's what you have available to you, but at least you've got a backup copy. One of the great rules of thumb is simply this. Consider your data. Consider the data that you're storing online, be it your email, your OneDrive, your photos, any of those kinds of things. What would happen if that service disappeared? Again, that scenario isn't likely. I've talked about that. But what happened if it disappeared? Because that actually covers all of these scenarios. Losing access to it is the equivalent of it disappearing. Would it be a problem? Would it be a disaster? Or would it be an inconvenience? As long as it's an inconvenience only, then you're in pretty good shape. But if the thought of, without warning, losing your email account completely sends a shiver down your spine, you need to take action. You need to start backing it up. In fact, you should be backing everything up anyway. But I've been saying that for a long time. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/170468. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.